Shout out to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. So, Conan Exiles, the famous or infamous game with the dong slider. Let's take a look. To start out, you have male or female, and although you don't see the character until you pick one, luckily you can just change it on the fly. You don't actually have to go back to the other menu screen in order to pick it again. And then we have race, which is not necessarily race, more like presets, but the reason they call it race is because I think it ties into the Conan lore, which I know nothing about. But there is a fun little blurb underneath for each one if you're into that whole role-playing business. Then after that you have a starting religion, which depending on which one you pick will give you specific gameplay bonuses or benefits from the looks of it. I don't actually know how much this plays into the game because I've never played this game. And you can gain favor with each of these religions by doing certain things in the game, like gathering human hearts and all that good stuff. From what I understand, you can learn every religion, so you're not just tied to the first one that you start out with, as long as whatever altars you have for them aren't too close to each other, which makes sense. Joe Crap, for example, doesn't want the longsword anywhere near him, even in the same continent, just out of fear of being tripped over. Then we have four voice presets here. Pretty standard stuff. Then head options, which is like general head stuff. We have a few head shapes here, which, oddly enough, there are less for male than there are for female, for some reason. Females have a few extra options. Then you have things like hair and eyebrows and facial hair, eyeshadow, you know, the usual. And all of those things have a set of colors that you can choose as well. And then we have face detail, which is the nitty-gritty. This is where you'll find the sliders for various parts of the face. Here we can see, you know, jaw and chin sizes, things like nose proportions, eyes can be tilted and resized and add the spacing, and pretty much every significant part of the face. Then we move on to body features, which is what it says on the tin. We have a height slider, which more so just resizes the character. You have the physique slider, which changes how intense their muscles are and how veiny you want them to be. And we have these other options as well, because as many of you probably know, Conan Exiles has full frontal nudity in it, and you have an option here, depending on what server you're playing on, to show none, partial, or full-on nudity, which is where the famous dong slider comes in, so yeah. And one last thing is every option on this menu can be randomized. Each one has a randomize button, which is pretty neat. So not a lot to this character creator so far. What's bad about it? Some nitpicks. Firstly, the background ambience consists of a constant drumbeat. It can be pretty repetitive, especially with those of you who like to take your time with character creators. Luckily, you can mute it, but it's still, you know, it just keeps going. When going through the face and hair options, the character flashes for a split second every time I go to another option, which is pretty disorienting and makes it really hard to know what's changing whenever you're going through different options sometimes. And it's just kind of irritating to look at. Minor problems with the menus. Whenever I try to scroll up or down, it like kind of shuffles and stutters in place, and it's a little annoying. Another minor nitpick, instant preview while hovering over the options. Subjective and minor, but I prefer selectable preview where it only appears on the character after you select it. Body size options are limited to just height, which will rescale the character's size and nothing further, and not even that much at that. You have this physique slider down here, but that's more for how pronounced you want the muscles to be rather than the actual body types. The common defense is that you're playing an athletic character in a fairly grounded world, which sure makes sense, but then there's a lot of things you have to suspend your disbelief for in video games in the first place. I'm sure we can extend it a bit further and have fat and skinny people do incredibly athletic things too. I think in a lot of cases that excuse doesn't really hold water when explanations and reasonings for things in video games can be pretty much whatever the creator wants them to be, and shouldn't be limited to what's realistic. Next, you can't really change your angle of viewing your character at all, aside from turning their head, because of the artistic choice of having them tied to this cross here, which thematically makes sense and works works within the context of the game, but I feel it gets in the way of a functional and user-friendly camera. You also can't zoom in or out at your own control either. You have to select a corresponding category in order to do so, and it always goes to a fixed amount. This isn't a massive deal since zoomed into the face, it does show a decent amount of detail and enough of the face to be able to make informed enough decisions, but I think having a little bit more control over the camera would be nice. One major problem I have with this menu is the same thing I had with Skyrim, is that a lot of the sliders for options I feel have no business being sliders. Like the hair and face and eyebrows and all that stuff, it makes comparing options really, really finicky. I think having visible previews of them would be much nicer on the user experience of this menu. If I ever wanted to look at one hair option and compare it to the other, I have to scroll through every single one first, instead of just being able to selecting which one from a grid or a series of panels or something along those lines. Another major problem, I feel as though there are not that many options to pick from as far as hairstyles and facial hair and face styles, especially for the men, considering they have less faces than the women. This is made up for by the, you know, being able to manipulate the face a little bit more, but that doesn't change, you know, the fact that there's not that many hairs, not that many beards. Could use a few more. And there are no unlockable or new hairstyles or beard styles from what I could find. All I could find were things like mods. So yeah, the game does not have that many choices for you. Overall, there's a lot to be desired from this character creator, as I feel it's fairly unremarkable in terms of what it lets you do. But every cloud has its silver lining, so what's good about it? Though I did cite the lack of body options as a negative, I gotta give props for the height slider, as it's more than most games get. Like, really, you'd be surprised how many games don't let you change your height. So I'll give Conan Exiles that one. Being tall or short can go a long way in distinguishing your character from each other, more often than people think. I can say the character model's quality, at least their face, is pretty good. Not the most amazing graphical fidelity, but it looks nice. Especially the hair. I like the hair a lot. It looks fluffy and soft, and it flows in the wind. Where I think this character creator shines the most is in the face options. There's quite a few sliders, and although maybe not as many as other games, they give you just enough control in the right places to get some pretty good results on some distinct faces. Just like, look at the eyes. You can change their size and angle and spacing, and there's a lot you can do with that. And if you don't believe me, look at the random button. There's a lot of different face shapes that you can do. That's always nice. And admittedly, the sex appeal sliders is something that I think is good depending on the subject matter of the game. In this case, the gritty, brutal, dark tone of the Conan universe, which is deep in classic barbarian style stuff, which includes a lot of casual nudity. And heck, it's filling a desire some people have in character creators that a lot of times is not catered to. I'm sure plenty of people enjoy changing their character's dick size, so having that option is good for them, filling a need and all that. Now, there might not be much to this character creator, but there's something to be said about only having to adjust a few things and then getting right into the game. There have been games in the past that I've put off covering just because of how overwhelming the character creators are, and I'm sure a lot of people have that same issue. So, sometimes, it's nice to just only have to adjust a few things and then jump right in. Conclusion. It's nothing special and fills the basic expectation of an average character creator with the bonus of having a few extra options, like a boob and dong slider, which is probably the only remarkable thing about it. It's okay.
Forget sex appeal sliders, you know what people find sexy? A sexy website. And what's the sexiest web building service of all? Today's sponsor, Squarespace. You know it's sexy because of how many S sounds are in it. The head honcho of quick and easy web building that anyone can use, so there's no excuse that there isn't a web shrine dedicated to the greatest weapon pairing of all time yet. If you need to try and recruit worshippers, you can use your omnipotent powers to see your page's visits, unique visitors, and page view trends over time and gain insight on where all those potential followers are coming in from. Provide a talking space so your devout and zealous followers can comment on how great the sword and shield is, where you can give them blessings via likes and replies for giving in to the one true path. One that promises oils and attack jewels to rain down on everybody like you're sitting under a bridge where an attack jewels filled truck just crashed and is spilling all of its cargo. You can purchase a domain directly from Squarespace with the best security this side of the Sword and Shield shield, so you too can focus all your time on piling offerings for it on a shrine made out of the finest of Kirin pelts. Go to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/joecat to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. And now you know how to become a follower of the Sword and Shield. You're welcome.
This has been Character Creator Critique. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.